안녕 친구. Currently, I'm at the Junggok station. I'm just about to meet one of my photography buddies. He was suggesting that we try this 시장 떡볶이. This place is quite far from the center of Seoul. See, I need to find exit 2. You wanna say hello?
I'll come in there. Hey, how you going, guys? Hey, it's been a while. We're back in Seoul.
You guys seen him in a previous video before. He took my photos for the Groove magazine and my own photos, you know, for my characters as well. We approach an entrance to the Junggok Jeil Golmok Shijang. But first, a little detour to get us to the tteokbokki shop. You guys, we're also gonna have some coffee bingsoo.
Yeah.
Is that the one you took photos for?
Yes, it is.
Oh! Oh wow! I've never been here before. So it looks like they sell a bunch of kimchi on this side, some dried goods, some dried seaweed I see, almonds. We have some kitchenware, pots and pans, Korean snacks, more kimchi, more banchan. This is where we're going? Oh, they have a bunch of fried food as well. 안녕하세요!
We gotta get bingsoo as well.
So. Oh yeah, let's not eat too much. You gotta squeeze in that bingsoo. How big is the bingsoo?
Bingsoo is pretty big.
So this is gonna be your appetizer and the bingsoo will be your entree. For those who are new to tteokbokki, tteokbokki is a Korean dish made of rice cake, chili paste, and fish cake. Toppings may include scallion and sesame seeds. The ideal tteokbokki is sweet, spicy, and chewy. Your tteokbokki experience will vary depending on the vendor. Our dish was topped off with a mini salad of sliced perilla leaves and cabbage.
Yeah.
This is udon gungmul. Udon soup. It's super hot. Whew.
When you visit Korea, you'll see people rubbing their one-time-use wooden chopsticks, the kind you break apart in half. This is to smoothen out the rough edges and prevent splinters.
So we're mixing it like a bibimbap. And you see some sheets of fish cake in there.
Don't chop the down.
Oh, that's good.
It's awesome,
huh?
Yeah. Not too strong.
Mm-mm. Just the perfect amount of sweet there. And the sweetness doesn't linger too long. It just like enters your mouth and then says hello and goodbye. How often do you eat tteokbokki?
Well, a couple of times a week. My wife's a bit of a fiend. She loves it, so.
Cheers!
Cheers.
What a great pairing with a tteokbokki. So they don't have a business card, but this place is called Kongine. If you put that on Google Map, this place should pop up. And it's really close to one of the entrances. And it's next to Mandu. And across from 불타는 족발. That's pig food on fire. That's what it means. So that was 3,000 won, which is about a little less than $3 USD.
This is a typical Gwangjin-gu, Dongil-ro street. Alright, so next stop is outside of an elementary school. So it's a children's tteokbokki store. And we can buy it in small cups for about 1,000 won. And this is advertising. Just given.
We just got candy.
Cross.
Oh, cross. What kind of candy did you give?
Oh, they gave us... Ge.
Ge?
Common ge.
Common ge? There's literally black sesame in this. Oh, I hope this doesn't change my taste, the experience of the tteokbokki. I think we're nearby, right? We're close to it?
Yeah, school's right here. So anywhere you find an elementary school, you're gonna find good tteokbokki.
Mm-hmm.
Always good. Kids run out at lunch to get a little 1,000 won cup of tteokbokki, right?
쭌쭈 분식. 안녕하세요. Here we have regular tteokbokki, you know, the spicy kind. And here we have 짜장 tteokbokki. You know 짜장면? Well, instead of using the noodles, we're using 가래떡 instead. The rice cakes.
They sell them for about 500, usually 500 won.
All right, so let's taste how different this tteokbokki is. It's definitely way softer, way thinner, and very sweet. And spicier.
It's actually spicier. I'm surprised at that.
It's spicier.
Yeah, it is. Yep.
I mean, this one is not like a hello, goodbye spice. It's like hello. It wants to stay. Let's try this jjajang tteokbokki. I'm assuming it's gonna be a little saltier, not as spicy.
For some reason, the rice cakes in this one is not as soft. Mm. Try it, Dylan.
Getting through that.
And it's not too salty either. It's much more mild.
That's actually pretty good.
And this is like good for adults, and this is good for kids.
This is quite sweet too, though.
Maybe it's because I had that candy.
Maybe.
Yeah. I think the sweet, I can't really taste sweet things anymore. Each little small cup costs 500 won, less than 50 cents each USD. Alright you guys, if you want to try the tteokbokki here, the address is Dongil-ro 72 Kid, okay? It's a long country.
Yeah, and traveling just takes so long.
So currently we're off to round 3 for the Coffee Bingsoo. Here's a look outside of the subway station. This is the Tuksum subway station. Oh, there's a lot of greenery. And we made it to the Bingsoo shop. It's called a Rusted Iron in Dumbo. Is that referring to the elephant Dumbo?
I think it's referring to the area of New York City.
Dumbo is a neighborhood in New York City and stands for Down Under the Manhattan Bridge Overpass.
There are 5 types of bingsoo here: the milk bingsoo, lemon bingsoo, cafe bingsoo, mango bingsoo, and grapefruit bingsoo. If it was springtime or autumn, it would be nice to sit outside, but it is hot. Oh, lots of space. Lots of room. Oh, best friend up there. And outside, that's the view. So we just got our bingsoo. This is looking so legit. I've never been to a bingsoo shop that actually sells it in mason jars. And it comes with a panna cotta and a little bit of red beans. If you look closely, they have some mochi in there, chapsal tteok, and oh, it looks like that's a piece of chocolate, the one that says rusted iron. We have a lot of work to do here, Dylan.
Yeah, I'm gonna get into it before it melts.
Oh yeah, let's dig in, It's a double-ended spoon. Is this the tablespoon end and this is a teaspoon end?
Little one for the panna cotta and the big one for the
pizza. Oh my gosh, I'm too excited. Oh, I just got a little bit of that coffee flavor and it's strong. The chapsal tteok is actually a little bit stiff because it's it got cooled by the bingsoo. But this, oh, got the ice.
Phenomenal, right?
Earlier, Dylan was saying this is like the best bingsoo shop he's been to thus far. And you're saying like it's not gimmicky.
It's just flavor.
It's just flavor. I agree. Okay, so this panna cotta?
Mm-hmm. It's really good.
So this has quite a bit of caffeine.
Oh yeah, yeah. You're gonna be awake for a couple of days.
Yeah. I'm very sensitive to caffeine.
Oh,
how about you?
Really? Yeah. I'm fine with it, so.
If it's past 3 and I have caffeine, I can't sleep until 12 hours later.
Oh really?
Typically. So we finished the bingsoo and...
That's it for the panna cotta. We're gonna finish that.
That's all you.
It's so good. I can't leave it behind.
See you, Dylan! I just got off a very packed subway ride. It is 6 p.m., so people are starting to get off work. There was a can of sardines in there. There's a girl next to me reading a book, and my hair, my strands of hair would be in her book, and as she turned the page, it'll tug at my hair. Right now, I'm just walking in my neighborhood. I've never been on the street. I didn't realize how many restaurants were lined around here. That's cool. Dong Daebak. Jjigae-jip. They sell stews there. Oh, and there's a little stream. Let's take a look. I hear some ducks. Let's walk over here. There's a lady selling some produce on the street. Lots and lots of restaurants. Some seafood, some dried goods. Here we have a bakery. Bang gumnun ajashi, the middle-aged man that bakes bread. Basically, at this point, I am just walking anywhere and trying to walk this caffeine off, work it out. I found these awesome set of stairs, so I'm gonna go up that, and it looks like it's all residential at this point. I'm not too worried about getting lost. I have a Wi-Fi egg that I carry with me everywhere. I'll just turn on my Google map and find my way back. So I walked into this neighborhood
And it looks so old school. I mean, this is Hanok. They have like the traditional roofing. I feel like I stepped into another decade. Do you hear that? Some guy is singing. I mean, this place is right next to the busy street filled with restaurants. It's like such a contrast. So I did some grocery shopping for dinner tonight. I got carrots. What else did I get? Mushroom, bell pepper, as well as a bag of almonds. I'm gonna toast them in the microwave. I'm supposed to eat only a handful, but I'll probably end up having like 5 handfuls. It was another successful and sweaty day. And this outfit, yep, gonna go straight to the laundry basket. I'll see you guys in the next travel vlog. Annyeong!